talking about governance, because the three themes that I put before the members is coming to a close, I fall back on the wise words of Thiruvalluvar. And this, it's very important, sir. We have heard several words of wisdom from Thiruvalluvar. Thiruvalluvar has spoken about what a good country is, what a good country is actually got to be like, and what makes up for jewels of a good country. I first read it in Tamil, then I'll give you the meaning. Pini inmai, selvam, vilai inbam, aimam. Pini inmai, selvam, vilai inbam, aimam. Ani enba, naattin vaindu. Ani enba, naattiv vaindu. There are five, what Thiruvalluvar says, which are jewels for a good country. The first is pini inmai, meaning you, the country will have to be without epidemics or illnesses, major illnesses. The second, he says, it should be wealthy. It should have wealth. It should have wealth. Vilaivu, it should also have velachal, in the sense from the fields it should have good crop. It should have inbam. It should have happiness. It also should have aimam, which is security and safety of the country. Sir, the five jewels. Five jewels. Pini inmai, selvam, vilaivinbam, aimam, and inbam. Prime Minister Modi. Prime Minister Modi. Ayushman Bharat. Ayushman Bharat for health for all is pini inmai. Selvam. Wealth creators will be respected in this country. Wealth creators will be respected in this country. Selvam. Vilaichal. Having good crop. Farmer PM Kisan. Doubling of income. Use of fertilizers and proper growth leads to surplus in horticulture, surplus in tilhan, surplus now probably also in dalhan. So the Prime Minister's program at health, at creating and giving respect for wealth creators and improving agricultural output and looking at ease of living, bringing happiness to people and above all, the fifth, aimam. This country's national security. You have enough proof to say national security is the top priority of this government. So, if Thiruvalluvar, if Thiruvalluvar,
आपको कुछ होना चाहिए तमिल में पढ़ा है बैठ जाइए.
That's right, sir. If Thiruvalluvar identified the five jewels for a good country, those five jewels are the ones which Prime Minister Modi is now addressing through his programs. For health, Ayushman, for wealth creators, a respectable and honorable climate, good crops, happiness through ease of living, and national security. So, now with all that said, the bouquet of flowers which I would like to give every citizen with trust and faith, with trust and faith, had flowers and aspirational India, had aspirational India, a set of flowers and aspirational India, had set of flowers and environment and economy and also commerce and industry. A third set of flowers was under the caring India, caring society that we want to have. Now this bouquet of flower is held by two hands, governance and the other financial institutions. I speak about governance, sir, which is very important. Good governance is what is going to be giving faith to the people. Honorable Speaker, sir, all the while I have explained the color and composition of the bouquet of flowers, schemes and programs. They were grouped under aspirational India, economic development and caring India. Now I speak about the two hands that will hold them. One such a hand is governance, which is clean, corruption-free, policy-driven, and good in its intent. And most importantly, trusting in faith, trusting every citizen, the aspirational youth, the hard-working women. Speaker, sir, trusting every citizen, I repeat, trusting every citizen, the aspirational youth, the hard-working women, the risk-taking entrepreneur, the ever-hopeful and untiring farmer, or the wise and old senior citizen. Many among them are taxpayers. Others may not be taxpayers now. Our Prime Minister has laid before us ease of living as a goal to be achieved on behalf of all citizens. An important aspect of both ease of living and ease of doing business is fairness, efficiency of tax administration. We wish to enshrine, this is important, Honourable Speaker. This is important, sir. Money being allocated to various programs is finance of this country. This is very important, sir. Businesses should have the confidence that things are being fair and the efficiency of the tax administration. We wish to enshrine in the statutes a taxpayer charter through this budget. A taxpayer's charter is getting institutionalized into the statutes. It's going to be enshrined as a part of our laws. That's building trust. A taxpayer's statutes will be a part of our, a taxpayer's charter will be a part of our statutes. Our government would like to reassure taxpayers that we remain committed to taking measures so that our citizens are free from harassment of any kind. We mean it, and we are willing to put it in the law. Tax harassment cannot be tolerated when we are talking about citizens and wealth collectors. There has been a debate about building into statutes criminal liability for acts that are civil in nature. This is important, sir. There has been a debate about building into statutes criminal liability for acts that are civil in nature. Hence, for Companies Act, certain amendments are proposed to be made that will correct this. Similarly, other laws would also be examined where such provisions exist, and attempts would be made to correct them also. The government intends to introduce major reforms in recruitment to non-gazetted posts in governments and public sector banks. At present, candidates have to appear for multiple examinations conducted by multiple agencies at different points of time for similar posts. This places enormous burden on time, effort, and cost for young people. To mitigate the hardship so faced, it is proposed to set up a national recruitment agency as an independent, professional, specialist organization for conduct of computer-based online common eligibility test for recruitment to non-gazetted posts, a test center in every district, particularly in the aspirational districts, would be set up. For speedy disposal of commercial and other disputes, government has constituted various tribunals and specialized bodies. It is